No Mai Hokimai, welcome back. Nice to have you with us. A retiring woodwork tutor must surely have set a New Zealand record for the fewest sick days taken over a 50-year career.
This is Gary Ashby's final week at Ara Te Pūkenga in Christchurch, where he's been teaching joinery and cabinetry since 1973. His only day off sick was in 1978. There's a whole lot more that's remarkable too. Here's Jendy Harper.
Gary Ashby, Department of Trades. Would be a handy person to have in a quiz team.
Yeah, if it's about wood, I'd be right. Yeah.
You know your wood.
I know the woods, yep.
He can take the history of the humble chair and expand on it.
Thought I ended up having five sons and he left the factory to each one of them, making about a million cafe chairs at that time.
Over 55 years, first as a student, then as a tutor, he must have walked this corridor at Ara Institute a million times or more, never tiring of its timber treasures.
By around about 1500, they came up with the idea of doing a mortise and tenon joint, and that's exactly how we make windows today with mortise and tenon joints.
Thanks to Gary, I now know a hardwood from a softwood.
Your deciduous is going to fall off in the winter time, and so that's a hardwood. But over here, they've all got needles on them like the pine tree, and they're not going to fall off, and that's the evergreen, so that's a softwood tree. Then we go through whether they're imported timbers, exotic or native timbers.
Gary has worked with them all, moulding, sculpting and shaping young lives too.
Just make sure you keep those hands behind that sharp edge on that chisel.
In 1968, when Gary was about the same age as these students, he came here to do his apprenticeship and made a shoeshine box.
Yep, I don't know that anybody else would have kept, but Mum kept all of that.
So you got the top second year apprentice and the top third year apprentice.
Yeah.
You can see why the bosses didn't want to lose him, so they offered him a teaching role. That's Gary on the left without a tie.
It was so dangerous on the machine that your tie would fall out and get caught up in the machine. So I was maybe a bit of a rebel and I said, I'm not going to wear a tie. And once I removed my tie, everybody started to remove their tie. So it did change, yeah.
Change has been a constant.
One of the options we could do is we could put a drawer in the bottom.
And he's adapted to meet the changing needs of his students.
I've picked up on their learning problems, that they can't read drawings, they can't do calculations, and that was a bit of a challenge. I found that three-dimensional drawings is what they like to see.
Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you.
I was never going to go to university, and it was a hands-on thing, and all of these kids are exactly the same as what I am. They love making things with their hands.
You can always take a bit off them, but you can't put it back onto them.
Gary Ashby is part of the furniture here.
Heard of Shackleton and he had planted that tree, so that tree is now 106 years old.
Lovely wood.
Yes.
Coming to the same place every day except for one.
I had one day sick leave in those 55 years.
One day.
I had tonsillitis in 1978 and I had to have one day off.
One day off work in half a century. He's as tough as old nails.
It's not to say I haven't been sick and I haven't been in hospital, but it all worked out. It was in holiday time.
And he always had the students at heart, and I think that's the thing where Gary is just one out of the box.
Retirement begins next Monday.
What will you miss?
I'll miss the equipment that's here. I've got tools at home, but I hardly ever use them because the equipment is so much better here to use. So it will be the equipment that I'll miss, yep.
Gary's hoping to keep teaching the odd night class while he's still hale and hearty. Touch wood.
Every day's been a good day to come to work.
Sick days, isn't it?
Yep, just like us.